Feel. Hear, feel, think. Yeah.
Deep in the sun-baked south, surrounded by the shifting sands of an endless desert, she rises. A solitary rose amidst the dust and rock, a symbol of defiance. Her name, Uldah. Even with the coming of the seventh Umbral Era, hope springs eternal for the mongers and merchants who vie for lost fortunes in this bustling oasis. As the twin faces of Nald Thal maintain their vigil over all that has been and shall be, the present proffers a brave soul. One whose arrival could mark the beginning of a new era of prosperity for the realm. May the traders nurture our fortunes as they kindle the flames which burn within us all. For by fire are we reborn.
Oh, Sultan Tree, hallowed spirit of my line, forgive my weakness. My failings have cost us dear. Show yourself!
As you command, O Lilira. Forgive my selfish desire to assure your welfare.
I don't recall requesting an escort. Simply pretend we never met and continue on your way.
We both know I can do no such thing. It isn't safe for you here alone. It isn't safe for anyone. Not with this etheric disturbance. It's as though the dead are watching us. And I'd prefer not to join them, if it's all the same to you. Ah, you must be the one the Papa Shan mentioned. Congratulations on finding our elusive young charge. You'll have to forgive her impetuousness. What she lacks in discipline, she makes up for in stubbornness. You should return with us. The station master will be eager to thank Lady Lilira's protector in person. Alas, the station master will have to wait. Dear Lilira, for my sake, please stay out of harm's way. As for you, dear friend, for Lilira's sake, please stay in harm's way.
Hear, feel, think. Crystal Bearer. I am Hydaelyn, all made one. A light there once was that shone throughout this realm, yet it hath since grown dim. And as it hath faltered, so hath darkness risen up in its stead, presaging an end to life. For the sake of all, I beseech thee, deliver us from this fate. The power to banish the darkness dwelleth in the crystals of light. Journey forth and lay claim to them. By thy deeds shall the crystals reveal themselves to thee. Only believe, for the light liveth in thy heart. Go now, my child, and shine thy light on all creation.
Ah, coming around now.
Me what that was?
If I only knew. A denizen of the void, at any rate.
The void sent? Yeah, but how?
The question isn't how, but who. We're not dealing with bookless bandits. Don't suppose the answer came to you in a dream? No sooner did you fell the beast than you fell asleep. Too much ether, no doubt. Interesting. I hadn't considered the crystal. But of course, this changes everything. Oh, just thinking aloud. At any rate, we haven't a moment to spare. I must return and report this at once. I leave Lady Lilira in your capable hands.
How dare you pass me about like a swaddled babe? I shall return and tell them myself.
As you wish, your impetuousness. I suspect we shall meet again before long. Until then, do try and stay awake.
Thank you. Royal Majesty, Nanamo Ulnamo presides.
Long live Nanamo!
Long live
Nanamo! Glory to the Sultana!
Glory to the Sultana!
Forever may she reign!
Forever may she reign!
They regaled me with tales of a champion amongst champions, once whose tireless service to the crown merited the highest honor we might bestow. Never did it occur to me that it might be you. Bring it forth! Betokening our gratitude and esteem, I, Nanamo Ulnamo, Sultana of Uldar, confer upon you this gift. Rauban?
Your Grace.
See to it that our champion is my personal guest at the banquet.
As you command, Your Grace. If what they say is true, Uldar owes you a great debt. I am Rauban al-Din. With the consent of Her Grace, I oversee the affairs of the Sultanate. Brave souls are few and far between in these times. I count my blessings when I find one. Her Grace invites you to join her at the coming banquet. I trust I will see you there.
An honor!
Huzzah!
Indeed.
Come, hero!
Until then, for the sake of Her Grace and the glory of the Sultanate, may you walk in the light of the crystal. All hail the Sultana! Your Grace.
Rauban? By right of the Royal House of Ul, I, Nanamo, 17th of my line, have summoned you here. We are graced this day by the presence of a hero to Ul'dah and dear friend to the crown. Honored guests, I give you our champion! And with that, I bid you enjoy the feast.
Not to spoil your appetite, but Ul'dah is hardly so bountiful as this meal would have you believe. While we gorge ourselves, children starve in the streets. Nor can her grace do aught to help them. She is thwarted at every turn by those on the Syndicate who derive their wealth from the workers' poverty. Beneath her mask of stately serenity, she is aghast at the plight of her subjects. But there will be no hope for the masses until the crown is restored to power. I am truly grateful for all you have done for Ul'dah. But there is so much more to do. That light, what is it? So bright, almost like by the 12. Tell me true, have you been troubled by strange dreams of late? Visions of the crystal? Mayhap you put them down to an excess of ether. Yes, you are like they were. Allow me to explain. Before you came to Eorzea, there were others like you who fought the primals. Though they were not of this land, when the Garlean Empire threatened the realm, they helped bring together the three grand companies. And they stood with us at Cartano, that fateful day 5 years ago. The day we lost them. None who survived have forgotten the hero's sacrifice, nor would any man deny they fought alongside us. But the names of these heroes come not to our lips. The once familiar pages of their story are now blank to us. And in our mind's eye, their faces are naught but silhouettes amid a blinding glare. It is for this reason that we have come to call them the Warriors of Light. When I look at you, I cannot help but think of them. And of what you might achieve. You must protect that crystal at all costs. It is a gift from Hydaelyn, mother of all, and one she gave to you for a reason. Yours is no ordinary tale. If I am right, the fate of the realm may yet hang upon your deeds. Only heroes and martyrs are fit to bear such a burden. Let us pray you are the former.
Flames to the fore! Victory belongs to the bold. Show those Imperial whore sons what we're made of!
The left flank buckles. Divert the barracudas. Bid them hold that position, though it cost them their lives.
The yellow serpents are in need of succor. Pray, send the white wolves to their aid. The adventurers risk life and limb for our cause. We must not fail them.
Is aught amiss?
No, it is nothing.
Bloody hells!
The barrier won't go down so easily! Eyes forward!
We are being watched.
Raging Bull, calling Bloodthorn. Bloodthorn, respond! Respond, damn you!
Raging Bull, this is Mad Snake. Respond.
Rider, this is Raging Bull. What news?
We're surrounded by a blaze. There is no way out. Gods preserve, what is that thing?
What's going on? Speak to me!
Gods damn it! We cannot hold much longer!
Mad Snake! Mad Snake! Answer me! Damn it! Damn it all to the seventh hell!
What of the barracudas? Can they not be reached?
Sorry, Admiral. Shell's not working.
What of our own?
I cannot say, my lady. That monstrosity appears to be disrupting our communications.
We must keep trying. Call till they respond.
Yes, my lady.
Admiral, General, we can do no more. We must give the order to withdraw.
I will not forsake Louis Soir!
General, please. Victory may belong to the bold, but there will be no victor this day. You know this to be true. Let us not sacrifice lives in vain. The adventurers fight bravely, but to no avail. Let them withdraw, and let us be the ones to stand with Louis Soir.
Belay previous orders. All Maelstrom units are commanded to fall back, effective immediately. Give the foreign levy priority. Let the main host cover their retreat and bring up the rear.
Damn it! Relay the order. All flames are to withdraw. I don't care if our link cells are useless. You still have a working pair of legs, don't you? Well, use them, you bloody halfwit!
The outcome of this battle was long since decided. Better to retreat now than risk a massacre. This dark, stifling presence. Who or what? We go to take our place beside Archon Louissois. To your positions.
Kasba Mool, Sogin Mwese Donzul. Logalo, Asawad Deken Bet Mubut. Imarat Way, Kiskatoga Hats Wadadorns. Seasnigem, Fizdun the only Lamrai Sadai Dorn.
It has been 15 years, but the bitter taste of defeat lingers still. 15 years since the Imperial fleet set course for Mordona, led by the Egrios, mightiest of all vessels. Silver Till Lake lay ripe for the taking, and all of Eorzea would soon be ours. Or so we believed. But an innumerable host of dragons met us that day, at the heart of which flew the great Meat Guard Zormer. Though we succeeded in slaying that lord among worms, the Dread Serpent's defeat was bought at too high a price. Our invincible flagship was lost, and all hope of victory with her. So ended our glorious conquest. Eorzea, a blighted realm, riddled with false gods. Twice now it has eluded the Empire's grasp. For all the destruction it wrought, even Meteor, the Great Sin, failed to yield us control over it. And for this failure, the realm has sunk deeper into depravity. It is twisted beyond all reckoning, rotten nigh to the core. Yet, it must be saved. Only Garlean rule can bring order to Eorzea. It falls to us to deliver the misguided masses from their ignorance.
We are of one mind, Lord Van Balthazar.
Senior engineers, please report to Magitek Research following scheduled inspection. Hey, is the Legatus really planning to take another tilt at Eorzea?
Hey? What hole have you been hiding in? We're in the midst of preparing for a new campaign, and a huge one at that.
But I thought the Emperor had given up the Western lands for lost after Cartano. What could the Legatus possibly hope to gain by acting alone?
I sense you harbor certain doubts over the wisdom of the Legatus's plan.
My lord!
Please, call me Nero. Tell me, where were you born?
Othard, my lord.
Alamigo, my lord.
Ah, codename Hummingway, I presume?
I don't know what you...
Silence. Your denials will not change your fate. I assure you, Frumentarium sees all. Clean up this mess, and do not miss any, or I shall be most displeased.
At once, my lord.
Garland, soon you will be made to know the true power of Magitek.
enter.
So the silver-tongued merchants send an adventurer to speak for them. It appears the Uldans place great faith in you. This way. I bid you welcome. I am Melvib Blufisvin, Admiral of Limso Lominsa, and Commander of the Maelstrom. Now, what news from Thanalan?
So you are the Uldan envoy. On behalf of our fair nation, I bid you welcome. Please. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Kane Senna, Elder Seedseer of Gridania, and leader of the Order of the Twin Adder, our nation's grand company. I understand you bear a message from the Flame General.